Good evening, everyone. Today we are going to see about CPU scheduling. There are various types of CPU schedulings are there. First one is FCFS, second one is SJF, and third one is priority, and fourth one is round robin. In this video, we are going to see about how the working CPU is working has been scheduled and a problem related to the CPU scheduling. First CPU scheduling, FCFS is nothing but first come first serve. In this, what the drawback is, actually the process which is coming first will be served first and it will be scheduled first. So in the FCFS, the longest process, for example if a process of huge burst time is coming first, then automatically the process which is having less burst time will be taking some more amount of time to complete its work. So this will lead to starvation, and to overcome the starvation, the second CPU scheduling algorithm has been introduced. It's nothing but shortest job first. This shortest job first is nothing but the CPU will schedule according to the burst time of the process. Burst time is nothing but actual time taken to complete its work. Then third one is priority scheduling. Some priority has been assumed to some processes and accordingly it has been scheduled. And fourth one is round robin. Round robin is nothing but FCFS in circular fashion. That is, in this scheduling algorithm will be fine, we will have a time quantum accordingly will be changing from one process to another. So now we will be discussing a problem related to CPU scheduling. In this problem we are going to see how we are going to draw the Gantt chart related to FCFS algorithm. First, before going to the problem, we should know what is average waiting time and what is burst time. Waiting time is nothing but process which is not going to take place in any other job. That is nothing but process in idle state. Process in idle state is nothing but waiting time taken for the process. And burst time is nothing but total amount of time that is taken to complete its work, which includes waiting time as well as burst time. That is what actually turnaround time is. Turnaround time is waiting time plus burst time. Okay, now we will be going to this problem. First, we have to draw the Gantt chart. Gantt chart for the given problem. In this problem, we are having 5 processes. P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. The process has been arrived at the order P1, P2, P3, P4, P5. All the process starts at the time 0. So first process is P1. What is the burst time is 2. So it takes 2 milliseconds to complete its work. Second is P2. So here comes the P2. It starts from, since this is FCFS, we have to execute the process in first come, first out. So this is first serve, then the second one, that is P2 will be serving. What is the waiting time is nothing but 1. So 2 plus 1 is 3. Then comes the P3. P3, which is having burst time of 8, it is the largest one. So 3 plus 8 will gives 11. And next one is P4, which is having burst time of 4. 11 plus 4 is 15. And then P5, which is having burst time of 5. 15 plus 5 is nothing but 20. Okay, now we are going to find the waiting time of P1. This one, actually the process comes at the time 0, then it has been immediately served. So waiting time is nothing but P1 is 0. So next, waiting time of P2 is 2. That is nothing but it also arrived at the time 0. Since the first process has been served for time 2, it has been allocated at the time 2. Then it goes on till for P3 it is 3 and P4 it is 11 and for P5 it is 15. So total waiting time of the process is 31. Average waiting time is 3.2 milliseconds. Now we are going to find the turnaround time of the process D1. Turnaround time is nothing but total time taken to complete its work. That includes what? Waiting time plus burst time. So waiting time of the P1 is 0 and burst time is 2. So total turnaround time is 2. Then for P2 it is waiting time is 2. So waiting time of P2 plus burst time of P2. That is 2 plus 1, 3. For P3 it is 3 plus burst time is 8. So it is 3 plus 8, it is 11. For P4 it is waiting time is 11 plus burst time is 4, which is nothing but 15. And for P5 it is waiting time is 15 and burst time is 5 and we get 20. So the total turnaround time of the process is 51 and average turnaround time of the process is 51 by 5, which is equal to 10.2. Okay.